Hello, I'm Michael Carter, Distinguished Professor of Agricultural and Resource Economics at the University of California, Davis, where I direct the Feed the Future Innovation Lab for Markets, Risk, and Resilience. We've been working with Agrilinks for at least 5 or 6 years. We've had over 31 items posted on Agrilinks, and we've hosted 2 or 3 webinars thanks to Agrilinks. Agrilinks has been a great help to us as academics, and especially as economists. We're very good at communicating with our own type, often using obscure language that most people find frustrating, if not downright impenetrable. However, Agrilinks is good because it demands of us a clear definition of the problem, clear definition of the solution in ways that are concise and understood by people who may not speak the magic language of economists. As we look forward over the next few years, I think some of the biggest challenges we face are related to climate change. Climate change is accelerating. It's getting worse. There aren't any climate change deniers in agriculture, as far as I can tell. At the same time, even though this problem is worsening, we now have better tools that can help farm families manage their climate-related risk, that make them more resilient to the predictable shocks like extreme drought. We've also learned that when families are better protected from losing their crops or their livestock to climate risk, they tend to invest more in growing larger or more profitable crops that ultimately can raise their income. This is what we call resilience plus. That is, if you can make a family, help a family with improved tools become resilient, then they can actually radically change their behaviors in ways that improve their standard of living and in many instances can put them on a pathway out of poverty. As we look forward trying to improve food security around the globe over the next 10 years, what might we do? What might we hope to see? We know because of accelerating climate change that governments, households, families, communities are going to need better tools to help them manage climate-related risk. These include financial innovation, something that we work on a lot at our innovation lab, but it also includes agricultural innovations like stress-tolerant seed varieties. Agrilinks is the place that we will continue to look for as we devise new solutions, as we test their efficacy. Agrilinks will be the place we look for to help us get that information out into the hands of those who can put it to very best use. So happy 10th birthday, happy 10th anniversary, Agrilinks. It's been wonderful working with you. And on behalf of my innovation lab and myself, we very much look forward to continuing our partnership.